हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल क्रोशे विद ज़ारा। आर यू रेडी टू ऐड अ कोजी स्टाइलिश पीस टू योर वार्डरोब? टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू मेक दिस ब्यूटीफुल लॉन्ग रिप्ड क्रोशे कार्डिगन। इट्स परफेक्ट फॉर दोज चिली डेज एंड कैन बी ड्रेस्ड अप और डाउन फॉर एनी ओकेजन। This cardigan is not only super comfy but also really easy to make. Even you are a beginner, you will find this pattern straightforward and enjoyable. We will be using a simple rib stitch that creates this lovely texture and gives the cardigan a professional look. So grab your favorite yarn and hook and let's get started on this amazing project together. For this project, I am using 4-ply yarn. It's a Turkish brand yarn. And a hook of 5.5 mm, some stitch markers and measuring tape and a scissor. Now let's get started by making the front panel of the cardigan. For the front panel of the cardigan, first we have to make total of 140 chains. Make a slip knot, insert the hook into the loop and tie the knot. Now make total of 140 chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now that I have made total of 140 chains, now I will we will be using a half double crochet slip stitch pattern in this cardigan. Yarn over, skip these two stitches and insert the hook into the loop, chain and pull up the loop. You have three loops on the hook. Now pull the last loop through these two loops. This is half double slip stitch. Now again yarn over, insert the hook into the chain, pull up the loop, three loops on the hook and pull through two without yarning over. Now yarn over, insert the hook into the loop. You have three loops on the hook and pull the last loop through these two loops. Now follow the stitch pattern until the end of the chain. Now follow the same stitch pattern and reach at the end of the chain. Okay, I will meet you at this point. Now that I have reached the end of the chain, now chain one and turn your work. Now yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop only and pull up the loop and half double slip stitch. Yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop only and pull up the loop and slip stitch into the two loops. Now yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop only and slip stitch through the two loops. Now in the same way, work half double slip stitch to the end of the row. Okay, I will meet you at this point.
Now that I have reached the end, now chain 1 and turn. Yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop only and pull up the loop and slip stitch through these two loops. Now yarn over, pull up the loop, slip stitch through these two loops. Now follow the same stitch pattern and make total of 43 rows for the front panel. This is the one panel of the front. This is an open cardigan, so we have two panels for the front. This is an open cardigan, so we have total of two panels for the front, one panel for the back and two sleeves. Now work half double slip stitch all the way through the end of the row and continue making half double crochet until you reach the row number 43. Okay, I will meet you then. Now that I have made total of 45 rows, I have told you before that I'm going to make 43 in rows, but 43 rows are not enough for me, so I have decided to go two more rows more. So it is total of 9 inches wide and it is total of 33 inches long. So this is my front, one of the front panel. Now make the other one same as I described you. So I have made the other one same as it is. I just started with 140 chains and total of 138 half double slip stitch stitches. So now I am going to tell you about the back panel. So let's keep it aside. Now that I have made the back panel same as the front panel, I just started with 140 chains and half double crochet slip stitch in each of the chains, so resulting in the end of 138 stitches at the end. So I have made total of 103 rows. Now let me tell you the measurements. This back is 23 inches wide and same as the front, 33 inches long. So now it's time to make the sleeves. I have made one of the sleeves. Okay, I'll show you. I have made one of the sleeves. So it's same as the front and back panel, starting with 66 chains resulting in 64 stitches at the end. So the sleeve length is total of, if we skip the ribbing part, we have total of 15 inches long sleeves and 16 inches wide. So I have made the other part. Now I will show you how to do the ribbing. This is same as the front and back panel. There is no difference in between making, and this is the very very easy cardigan to make, especially for the beginners. Just start the chain and whole cardigan just based on only one stitch, half double crochet slip stitch in back loop only. So now it's time to do ribbing. So again I'll tell you the sleeves. Start with 66 chains resulting in 64 chains stitches at the end. So I have made total of 70 rows for the sleeves. Now change the hook size to 4.5 mm. Now I'm just going to start the ribbing for the sleeves. Now I am going to do a row of single crochet two together stitch. So just insert the hook into the row, first row, and insert the hook into the row that is just the other one, and now yarn over and pull through all the three stitches. Now insert the hook into the row, pull up the loop, and again insert the hook into the next row and pull up the loop. Now you have three loops on the hook. Now pull through all the three loops. This is single crochet two together stitch. Now again insert the hook into the next row and insert the hook into the next to it, and yarn over and pull through two. Now in the same way, work single crochet two together stitch in each row, and in the end you have total of 35 stitches of single crochet two together stitch. Now chain one, it is now turn your project. Now yarn over and work double crochet in each stitch. Now I'll catch you at this point. Now I have made total of 35 double crochets in the end, as we have made total of 70 rows for the sleeves. So if we crease these two rows into one stitch, then it should end up at 35 stitches. Now chain one and turn. Now I am going to do 6 rows of front post and back post double crochet. This is my first row. Now yarn over and insert the hook behind the stitch, double crochet, and pull up the loop. This is front post double crochet. Now yarn over and insert the hook at the back side of the double crochet and pull up the loop in front of it. Pull up the loop. You have three loops. This is back post double crochet. Now yarn over and put the hook on the front side back post double crochet, front post double crochet, back post double crochet, front post double crochet, back post double crochet, front post double crochet, back post double crochet, front post double crochet. Okay, I will meet you at this point. Now chain one and turn. Now in the back side we have to see which is front post and which is back post. In the previous row, if the stitch comes here front post, then after we turn the project, the front post will be over back post. So in this row I have just made front post double crochet. Now I am going to make a back post, and front post, just alternate the stitches according to the pattern. In the previous row this stitch was over front post, now in this row this stitch will be over back post double crochet. Front post, back post. Front post, back post. Front post, back post. You have to make the stitches according to the stitch that comes. If it comes front post, you have to make front post, and it is coming like a back post, so you have to make back post. Now I will make total of 6 rows. This is my third row. I will meet you after the 6th row. Now that I have made the sleeves, both the sleeves, now it's time to assemble the all the parts together. First we will be joining the shoulders both front panels to the back panels. Now put the back in such a way that front side facing you, and put the front panel in such a way that wrong side facing you. Now decide it yourself. Which side will be your front side or wrong side. Now put it in such a way that each row parallel to each other and sew it with slip stitch. Insert the hook into the first row of front panel and first row of back panel and attach the yarn. Now in each row work slip stitch rows parallel to each other . In the same way, join both the parts and the sleeves. For the sleeves, we have to find the middle point and just attach with the middle point of front and back panel and just attach it same as I am attaching in the with the slip stitch, or you can use a weaving needle. It's totally up to you. It's your choice. You want to go with slip stitch, you can go ahead, or a weaving needle, it's also your choice. But I am attaching the panels, all the parts of the cardigan with the slip stitch. Okay, I will meet you after joining all the parts, both the sleeves and front and back panel together. Now you can see I have assembled all the panels together using slip stitch. Now it's time to attaching the front and back panel. So start from the sleeves to the armhole and then sew the front and back panel from the sides using slip stitch or weaving needle. It's totally up to you, whatever method you want to use. I will go for the slip stitch. Okay, I will meet you then. Now put the sweater in a way and start sewing from this side to this end, armhole and front and back panel using slip stitch to this end. Okay, I will meet you after sewing the sweater. Then I will show you how to do ribbing for the bottom part and the for the remaining cardigan.
Now I have joined all the parts together. Now it's time to do ribbing for the bottom area. Now start from the front panel of the bottom area. Now just attach the yarn. And chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Now work double crochet in each row and I am choosing the hook size 4.5 mm. Now work double crochet in each row. Okay, I will meet you at the other side of the cardigan to the other front panel of the cardigan. Now, I have made a row of double crochet in each of the rows of the front and back panel. Now, I am going to chain 1 and turn. Now, yarn over and make a front post double crochet and for the next stitch make a back post double crochet. Front post double crochet, back post double crochet. Front post double crochet and a back post double crochet. Front post double crochet, back post double crochet. In the same way, work front and back post double crochet on alternative stitches and reach the end of the row and then chain 1 and turn and again work front and back post double crochet. Just make sure after turning the project the post double crochet will be over back post double crochet. So I have just described this ribbing pattern on the sleeve section, so I'm not going to show you the whole pattern of the ribbing on the bottom. And in the same way will work the front and back post double crochet on the sides of front panel and go through all the way to the neck and the other side of the panel. Okay, I will meet you after after doing the ribbing. And there you have it, your very own long ribbed crochet cardigan. I hope you had as much fun making it as I did. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel @CrochetWithZara for more fun and creative crochet project. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you will never miss a new video. I would love to see your finished cardigan. Be sure to share your creation on social media and tag at me @CrochetWithZara. You can also leave a photo in the comments below. Your work always inspires me. If you have any questions or run into any trouble, leave a comment below and I'll do my best to help you out. And if you have any suggestions for future tutorials, I'd love to hear them. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Until then, see the video of your own choice given on the screen. Thank you so much for watching the video.